In this video, we are going to discuss about the booting up of a router or a switch. How this boot process starts. You see here, when you power up a Cisco router or a switch, it will first run the power on self test, which is called POST, post. After the POST, then it looks for the Cisco IOS from a flash memory and it will try to load the Cisco IOS. So here flash memory is an electronically erasable, programmable, read-only memory, so that from here the Cisco IOS will be loaded. After the Cisco IOS loads, it looks for the configuration file in the non-volatile RAM. So we will be taking a look of a booting process of a Cisco router here, and the router is a 1841 router. So here is the first step. First part shows the information regarding the bootstrap process, which runs the post and then tells the router to load the Cisco IOS. So by default, the location of IOS is the flash memory. So here, from the flash memory, the Cisco IOS loads. The next part shows the IOS image being compressed, and after the compression, the pound sign shows the progression of the decompression here. So you take, this is the output. So this is the output truncated, and it is a post self test, and decompressing takes place here of the image here. So this pound sign shows the process of decompression. So after this one, if you see, after the decompression, the IOS loaded the RAM and starts to run. So here the configuration file is taken from the non-volatile RAM and it will start to run. So during the startup of lot information is shown here, you can see this is the output here. So you can see the information like Cisco software of 1841 router, and it is of the version 12.4/25E. This is the version, and the release also is mentioned here, which is FC2, and the technical support information of the Cisco is also, and also the details of the router is shown clearly here. So after this process, once the IOS has completely loaded, it will display important information of the router, and also during the post what it is learnt, and also about the booting information. So you can see the make of the router, flash and RAM size in the below result here. You can see it is having a memory of this much bytes, and the processor board ID is this. It has two fast Ethernet interfaces, one virtual private network VPN module here, and also you can see about the DRAM configuration of the bits, and also about the read and write capability of ATA compact flash here. So this is about the boot, after booting process and after the post information, whatever the switch or the router has learnt will be available in the result here. So after that, the output above shows it is of 1841 Cisco router and has total memory of 128 MB RAM and 191 KB of non-volatile RAM and 32 MB of flash. So it also has two fast interfaces here. So these two fast Ethernet interfaces, and also once IOS is loaded, it will copy the saved configuration, and this is called as a running configuration. And also the boot up sequence of type messages is very similar to router and switches. As we have seen about the router here, we will be taking a look of the switch as well. So you can see this is about the boot process of a Cisco Catalyst switch, and it is very similar that you see about the boot loader, which is loading here, and it is giving the release information of the software, and also it is given the version of the software as 12.1/11R. So this is about the message of the bootstrap program running in the backend, and you can see about the decompression here, which is executing. This is how the bootstrap process starts up. So after this one, after the IOS is decompressed and the iOS version is displayed, note the iOS version. This is the iOS version mentioned here, and afterwards this is the information, the iOS information given with the copy rated of Cisco Systems Incorporation. After iOS loads, it runs the post. So the self test is run with various components, and it will display about the various components, the test passed or not. So you can see system board test is passed, Ethernet controller test is passed, and front end loopback test is passed. So these are the similar, these are the simple components available on the switch. So this have passed the post process. After this one, the post is passed, IOS completely loading and displays the information of what it learnt in the post process. And these are all the details about the processor information, which is having bytes, and also the processor ID, which is having 24 fast Ethernet interfaces, 2 gigabit Ethernet interfaces. So this shows 2950 switch has 20 MB of RAM, 32 KB of flash. They are 24 fast Ethernet interfaces and 2 gigabit Ethernet interfaces in the switch. So after that, in both the case, the router and switch, if they start up, they have to follow from the bootstrap process, post process, and also configuration file loading, also Cisco IOS loading here. And also you can see the dialog box here that it has to present the device, and the setup mode of the system configuration dialog should be used here. So if you are not starting it with the proper sequence of the boot process, it will go in the system configuration dialog module. So here it will ask here, when you the result, if you see the system configuration dialog, it will ask, would you like to enter the initial configuration? The initial configuration start up with the post test, after that bootstrap process, and after that Cisco IOS loading and configuration file loading. So this is the actual process. If you are not, if this is not followed, the system configuration dialog box will appear and it will ask you or probe you to start the initial configuration. If you click on no, automatic select will be taken place by this dialog box here. So coming to the component and the function. So what we have read about some components here, and we will be looking about the functions here. What is a component of bootstrap? A small program that runs the post test and then loads the iOS on boot up. So this bootstrap process is like starting the post test and booting the iOS on the switch or the router. Coming to flash memory, it is electronically erasable programmable read only memory where iOS file is stored, so that the bootstrap looks for the iOS file first in the flash memory here. Coming to RAM, the working memory and also a copy of this configuration is stored in the memory after the boot up here. So after booting up, the saved configuration of the startup configuration is saved in the flash memory basis, that is called as a running configuration file. Coming to non-volatile RAM, it stores a copy of a configuration on boot up. iOS reads the configuration file from here. So the startup configuration file is available in the non-volatile RAM before the boot up process, so that it takes the configuration file when the boot up process is taking place. So this is all about the boot up process of the router and the switch, and also these are the components and their functions in the switch process of booting up.